One plasma sphere having undergone stellar ignition. Numerous spheres orbiting in the electric field of solar wind with direct magnetic connections back to the star. Let's apply what we've seen to the 2020 planetary geometries upcoming in the middle and end of the year. So far in this series, we've gone over a number of interesting correlations from the chart in our first book detailing the solar flare triggering during planetary alignments, including the biggest flares ever. We did the same with earthquakes. We've gone over the dozens of studies showing those correlations and showed how the focus has always been on the mechanism of subtle gravitational forcing on the sun by the orbits of the planets. But that's also the problem, because the missing piece of the puzzle is electromagnetism. As mentioned in previous episodes, the statistical correlations have never been challenged, but also, the science about how impossible it would be for the gravity of the planets to pull this off is sound itself. This is what has created such a controversy in the field. Yes, the only mechanism they've examined is pretty much impossible. But when we realize that the global electric circuit and geomagnetic system access the crust and mantle, and that all planets have magnetic and plasma exchanges with the sun, things become a bit different. And when we recall the ease with which a slight coronal magnetic field disruption can trigger a solar flare below, the importance of the return fields and return currents to the sun to solar flaring activity becomes quite obvious. By the way, those initial episodes were one of the first times we went over the rippling electric current sheet in the solar system, dividing the outflowing and return currents, and much more recently, like we've been discussing, in the galaxy. Now, in terms of those solar flares and earthquakes, we need to remember the most crucial thing, that clustering of planets only matters for gravity, but those clusters, where the planets are all on one side, does provide more alignments with that bunching, which we saw playing a role in the 2017 uptick on both the Sun and the Earth. And by the way, what we didn't know back in 2018 during those first four episodes was that we were in the midst of the longest magnitude 7 earthquake drought in recorded history. Our recent update on earthquakes where we cover that event is linked for you below this video, along with the first four episodes. Now, it's the start of 2020, and we've been looking forward to this for a while. With the latest confirmation that the planets are controlling the longer-term cycles of the Sun, like grand maximum and grand minimum, we look ahead to some of the more impressive alignment sequences in years. Right now, the Earth is actually sitting alone on one side of the solar system, and by the time the Earth gets over to the other side, we begin to have that same scenario discussed. With all the planets clumping together, we get about triple the normal amount of those significant alignments starting around June. It happens as Mercury and Uranus break the opposition across the Sun from each other. Mercury, Venus, and Earth are racing around and do their conjunctions with both Jupiter and Saturn, and then Mars, in a very short window, taking out the major planetary alignments of the year in about a sixth of the year. After things break up at the end of summer and into the fall, until Halloween, when Jupiter and Saturn are set to conjoin. This only happens once every 20 years. Jupiter's 11-year orbit allows Saturn to make a third of its orbit, which would only take Jupiter another 3 or 4 years to cover if Saturn wasn't also covering a 30th of the radial degrees each year at the same time. Now, while that once every 20 years event is ongoing, Uranus will be sitting due opposite of Earth from the Sun, and the inner planets will be doing their own dance of resonances there in the days before. With seismicity always in mind, we now have the start of a sunspot cycle to watch for as well. Will these be the excitation of significant activity to kick off cycle 25 this year? And what about the earthquakes? That's what we're going to find out. Be safe, everyone.